Did you know SOTI supports mobile devices from over 200 device manufacturers? We also support all the operating systems powering your organization's mobile devices. From Android to iOS, iPadOS, and macOS to Windows and Linux, SOTI delivers proven mobility management for your enterprise. Many organizations have hundreds, if not thousands, of mobile devices to manage, but keeping them organized can be quite challenging. Hi, I'm Jeff, and I'm a product marketer at SOTI. I'd like to show you how you can create and manage device groups in SOTI MobiControl to make it easier for your device administrators to organize and manage the mobile devices throughout your organization. Let's dive right in. All devices enrolled into SOTI MobiControl are organized into device groups. SOTI MobiControl has three default device groups: management, sales, and warehouse. However, you can create your own device groups to better suit your organization's needs and deployment strategy. For example, it might be useful to organize your devices based on geography or type of device rather than by department or the user's role. You can also nest device groups under each other to establish a hierarchy. All top-level or root device groups are listed alphabetically in the left side of the SOTI MobiControl console. Lower-level device groups are alphabetically nested under their root groups, and you can hide the device group tree by clicking the device group name in the search bar. When a device group is selected, the devices within that group appear in the devices list. The Include Subfolders option in the Search Settings dropdown determines which devices are displayed. When enabled, Include Subfolders show all devices under the device group, including devices in the device group nested under that selected group. When disabled, only devices directly within the selected group appear. You can also choose to see all your devices, regardless of device grouping, by clicking View All Devices. Grouping devices is a valuable tool for device administrators since it enables them to apply policies and configuration settings to devices at a group level, and those policies would then be applied to all devices in the subfolders nested under that group. This can save device administrators significant amount of time spent on configuring devices, as they can apply changes to many devices at once rather than a single device at a time. Remember, it's also important to take your console security into consideration when organizing your device groups, so keep that in mind when creating nested groups who will inherit the permissions you apply to that parent group. Okay, let's create a root device group. At the bottom of the device group tree, click New Group and select New Root Group. Enter a group name and click Create. Let's pretend I'm going to be managing devices for a multinational retail business and name this device group Flagship Stores. Once you've created a new root group, you can simply drag and drop devices into your new device group or create an Add Devices rule that targets the group folder. To create a subgroup, click on the three dots beside the device group you want to nest a subgroup under. Select Add Group and enter a group name for your subgroup folder and click Create. In each of my flagship stores, I want to create a subgroup for each type of role within that store. I'll name this child subgroup Managers. Just like with root device groups, you can just drag and drop devices into your new group or create an Add Devices rule that targets the new nested device group. If you want to rename a device group, you can click the three dots icon and then rename directly from that group. You also have the ability to create root virtual device groups. Virtual device groups enable device administrators to view devices that are otherwise found within different device groups together in one virtual group. To create a root virtual device group, navigate to the bottom of the device group tree and click New Group and select New Root Virtual Group. Enter a name for the new virtual group in the virtual group name field and click Create. Now you can drag and drop devices into your new virtual group. You can also nest virtual device groups by clicking the More menu button beside the device group under which you want to nest a new virtual device group. You can also nest virtual device groups under regular or virtual groups. Additionally, users can also add a filter to virtual groups to add matching devices. Although devices are added to device groups based on enrollment settings, they don't have to remain in those device groups. You can drag and drop them into a different device group or use device relocation rules to automatically move devices between groups based on changes in their IP addresses or other custom data that you can specify. It's important to remember that device configuration settings are often based on device group. When devices are moved between groups, their assigned device settings, profiles, and other configurations may be revoked or altered to match the new device groups. A device relocation rule moves devices between device groups depending on changes in their IP addresses or custom data identifiers. In deployments where device groups represent geographic locations and your devices regularly move from one location to another, a device relocation rule is a convenient way to automatically track those movements using device groups. Device relocation rules are available on the Android Plus, Linux, Windows Desktop Classic, Windows Mobile CE, and Windows Modern platforms. And those are the basics of creating and managing device groups using SOTI MobiControl. In just a few minutes, I've shown you how SOTI MobiControl makes managing your mobile devices easier than ever before using device groups. To learn more about the SOTI One platform and how it reduces the cost, complexity, and downtime of your business-critical mobile and IoT operations, visit www.soti.net.